Good morning. In previous session, we had discussed array. As we had earlier discussed that array is a collection of homogeneous data elements. Now, we have to learn that in homogeneity, if characters are collected, then that has a separate name and that is called string. We all use characters as well as strings for our various purposes, but more oftenly you people confuse that which one should be treated as character and which one should be treated as string. Now we will discuss in detail that what are the characteristics of a string, how strings are declared, how these are used in our computer programs in C programming languages. Now take, what is your name? If you say my name is such and such, and these two words such and such is a collection of characters with a blank space, all these are cumulatively treated as a string. If you say only your initial, suppose your name is Mukesh and you say I am M, that is that M1 will be treated as a character. This is the difference between character and string. Let's see, the characters are declared as simply the type C, H, A, R or any variable name which we want to suppose to be there, that N, A, M, E, name. The name variable will contain only one character, whereas if you have to store entire set of your name characters, then you have to declare that one in this manner, like C, H, A, R, N, A, M, E, name 1 within bracket 20. The second declaration, which suffix a square bracket containing some number, that is the actual declaration of a string. It means the name 1 is your variable name which can contain 20 characters, and your name may be within those length of characters. This is the characteristics of declaration of a string. Now we have to use this, as we had seen that various functions, library functions are available. Likewise, a string has some specific functions. We have some functions in which, this is the case of declaration of string variables. Now we should know how we will differentiate the string constant and character constant. To note down a character constant, we use single quotation mark. If we write A, this one is a character constant. Whereas we have to note down a string constant, we have to put double quotation marks. If we write welcome within this double quotation marks, it means it is a string constant. So this is the way by which we can write string constant and character constant. Now few functions are available which are used frequently to do string works, just like number one is strcat function. This is a function which is used to append one string behind the other string. Ek string ke piche dusre ko jodne ke liye we use strcat function. It requires two arguments. First is necessarily should be a string variable. The second may be either a string variable or a string constant. So likewise, if we have to copy a string constant to other string variable which has already a value, for that very purpose we use strcpy. Strcpy. This also requires two arguments. Here the second argument is the value of second argument is copied to the first argument. So this is to replace a variable which have already a value, but with a new value we use strcpy. strcmp, it is also frequently used for various purposes. strcmp, whenever it is required to compare two strings whether they are in same order or not, we use strcmp. It also requires two arguments. Here it is liberty that both may be a string variable, both may be a string constant, or either of them may be. Whereas this facility was not available with previous two one, that is strcpy and strcmp. So this is the another function which we frequently use in our various programs. The next one is strreb. Whenever it is required to revert a string, like that last one should be first, the second last one should be second, second one. So for that very purposes, we use strreb function. This requires only one argument. The one more function which is frequently used, that is strlen, that gives us the number of characters within a string. In so many occasions we require that how many spaces will be required for a specific string. In those cases we use strlen function. This requires one argument and it gives the result an integer value. It means it gives the number of characters which is contained in that particular string. For these various purposes, these are the few string functions which we oftenly used, and next in more in next lesson. Okay, thank you.